السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
إن الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله. أشهد أنه بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة فكشف الله به الغمة. فاللهم اجزه عنا خير ما جازيت نبياً عن أمته ورسولاً عن دعوته ورسالته. اللهم لا تحرمنا أجره ولا تفتنا بعده واجمع بيننا وبينه في مستقر رحمتك. ثم الوصية عباد الله، تقوى الله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، knowing that there are some brothers and sisters who have midterm, inshallah, we'll keep the khutbah short today to gain the benefit of the khutbah and also to give them an opportunity to return, inshallah, to their classes. We are in blessed days, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam described in the hadith narrated by Imam al-Tabarani rahimahullah and the authority of Muhammad ibn Maslama. قال رسول الله إن لله في أيام دهركم لنفحات ألا فتعرضوا لها، وفي رواية فعرضوا أنفسكم لها، فلعل أحدكم أن تصيبه منه نفحة منها نفحة فلا يشقى بعدها إلى يوم القيامة. In hadith narrated by Tabarani, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that indeed Allah has blessed days. There are days that has special breeze, that you could feel it. So Allah said, Rasulullah said, expose yourself to these days. Expose yourself to these days that you may gain the mercy of Allah. And if you gain the mercy of Allah, you will never be misguided again. We are coming to a blessed month, and the preparation has to start as soon as possible. Not today, not at Maghrib time. It should have started in Rajab and Sha'ban, but if not, we still have the time before Ramadan starts. في حديث مسلم من حديث أبي هريرة كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا أقبل رمضان استهل وجهه وصعد المنبر وخطب أصحابه فقال أيها الناس أظلكم شهر كريم مبارك فيه تفتح أبواب الجنة فلا يغلق منها باب وفي رواية مسلم فيه تفتح أبواب الجنة الثمانية وتغلق فيه أبواب النار فلا يفتح منها باب ولله في كل ليلة من رمضان عتقاء من النار وذلك في كل ليلة وفيه ليلة من أدركها قياما فهي خير من ألف شهر ليلة القدر. In the hadith of Imam Muslim rahimahullah and the authority of Abu Huraira, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, they said when Ramadan would arrive, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would show his happiness. And they could see that on his face, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam. He would show his happiness and he would stand on the minbar and telling people that Ramadan has arrived. Like a person who's telling or giving a glad tiding for someone that they have missed, like a traveler who has been traveling for a long period of time. Finally, he has arrived. Shahrun Kareem, this is a generous month. The month itself is generous in its ibadat, in the increase of iman, in getting you closer to Allah, in all the bounties and the blessings of Allah when most people are unaware of. The doors and the gates of paradise are completely open, all eight. The eight gates of paradise are open and they will not be closed till the last day of Ramadan. And all the gates of hellfire are completely shut down and they will not be reopened till the last day of Ramadan. In it there is a great night, which is Laylatul Qadr. And every single night Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala frees many of His servants, frees their neck from hellfire. May Allah make us among them. Allahumma ameen. Ramadan has come. We're only a few days to approach. Ramadan might be Sunday, Monday or Tuesday according to calculation or moon sighting. Well, we are only a day or two away from Ramadan. And the question should have been, what have we prepared for it? And let me start with this statement of Ibn Rajab rahimahullah ta'ala when he said, لو أن يقول ابن رجب لو حل بالإنسان ضيف عزيز عليه وبيته وسخ فبأي شيء يبدأ؟ يبدأ بزينة البيت أم يبدأ بتنظيفه أولا استقبالا لضيفه؟ Ibn Rajab said, if you have a dear guest who's coming to visit you, someone that you really love, and this is the point that I want to stop with. Do we really have that happiness for the month of Ramadan to arrive while we're alive? Or it becomes customs, it becomes tradition. The fasting becomes, alhamdulillah, first day of Ramadan, we have to worry about what? Buying food for the house, getting ready for iftar, making sure we have enough dates and milk. That's it? Is this the preparation for Ramadan that we got to? Well, so far, most Muslims, inshallah, it will not be us preparing. Most Muslims, this is their case. Ramadan becomes a seasonal practice, a traditional practice, more than the ibadat in Ramadan and the rituals of Ramadan and the virtues of Ramadan, which we're not aware of or familiar with. When the gates of Jannah are open, all eight doors are open for you to enter.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the angels to open them for his servants. And Allah shuts the doors of hellfire to tell us what? To tell us that if the doors of Jannah are open, we're only obligated in Ramadan to do our ibadat and be closer to Allah. And if the doors of hellfire are shut, we should not get ourselves closer to these gates and wait for them to reopen by making mistakes and falling into sins, by not taking the advantage of Ramadan. So Ibn Rajab said, if you have a dear guest who's coming to visit you at your house, and your house is kind of dirty, which is our hearts, your house is not very clean, do you start decorating the house to welcome your guest? Or do you start off first by cleaning the house and then decorating the house? Well, every one of us will agree that we have to clean up the house first. Okay? We make it clean. We make sure it's clean and neat and nice. And if the decoration comes in, alhamdulillah, if we don't have time for decoration, then it's fine. This is what we should do with our hearts before Ramadan. And the only way, brothers and sisters, to do that, and most of you would listen to this and just pass it by their ears, but I wanted you to pass it by your heart. We need to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You might say, well, this sheikh was talking today at Joe Room. I'm not doing anything wrong, man. Well, let me give you this ayah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the believers, not to us, and the believers at that time were the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Rasulullah said to them, وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. توبوا, توبوا. Allah said, repent. To whom? To the companions. After what? After the battle of Uhud. They were not enjoying life. I'm not going to say we're falling into haram. I'm going to assume, inshallah, none of us is doing haram. Which, our heart being distracted away from Allah is part of this haram and sin. But I'm not going to consider that. Let's just say we're just enjoying life. We're not doing anything. Well, you did not come back from the battle of Uhud, the battle of Badr, which Allah has forgiven all the people who witnessed the battle of Badr. Allah has forgiven all of their sins. We were not with them. We're not even close to them. No matter what, how good you are. MashaAllah, you are the most religious person in the United... on the universe. You're still not like the Sahaba who witnessed Badr. Because you're not guaranteed Jannah like they're guaranteed. With that, Allah is telling them, وَتُوبُ. Allah says, you need to do what? To repent. Why? Because there's that dirt in the heart. We don't enjoy Ramadan because we have built a wall between us and Allah. And this wall is made from sins. And the only way to do that is to destroy these sins. And it's very simple. Wallahi, it's very simple. All you need to do is a moment of sincerity with Allah, that this Ramadan will be different from any Ramadan. That's all it takes. When you come back to Allah, as hadith narrated by Imam Muslim, يقول العبد أي ربي فعلت ذنب كذا وكذا يوم كذا وكذا فاغفر لي فيقول الله لبيك عبدي. The word لبيك. Here I'm at your service. What do you want? We say that in Hajj, لبيك اللهم لبيك. We're here at your service, Allah. We're willing to do whatever it takes. We came here, we spend money, and we're here to say لبيك. We're all yours. We're coming, we're going to obey your commands. Well, when you make dua for Allah to repent and you return back and you admit your sins and say, oh Allah, forgive me, Allah will say, I am here for you. That's all it takes. The shaitan works very hard against you all year, and Ramadan comes, and all your sins are forgiven. Don't help the shaitan against yourself. Fight and defeat the shaitan, especially before Ramadan. Well, there's a lot to prepare. Siyam, which is too late now, because if you haven't started Siyam, there will be no point to start Siyam now. There is no point of fasting now. And it's dislike among most of the scholars, if not all, to fast these few days if you haven't started yet. Salah, oh, get ready because you have Taraweeh. You're going to be standing in Taraweeh. And you should have a goal and a plan for this Ramadan. The advice of this khutbah is that every one of us should make a theme for this Ramadan. Okay? Free yourself from whatever it takes to be free for Ramadan. Do whatever you need to do now before Ramadan starts. If you think you're going to waste a few days buying the food and the clothes of Eid already, which Ramadan didn't start, well, buy it now. Try to free yourself for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially the night time. Well, what is your theme for this Ramadan? Is it going to be fasting for sincerity, for ikhlas, that you get your sins forgiven? Could be. Your theme for this Ramadan, that I'm going to connect myself more to Quran, alhamdulillah. My theme, that I'm not going to miss one rak'ah from Taraweeh, alhamdulillah. If this is your only goal, focus on it. Come out of Ramadan with something. This is what you need to do. Preparation for Ramadan is to have a set goal and to work hard for it, to achieve it. And whatever shortcoming you do, know that Allah will forgive you for it. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. This is what Allah said. Allah would only hold you accountable for what you are able to do, what you are capable of, according to the capacity that you have. Allah will not pardon you with something that you can't take. So this is my goal for Ramadan. This Ramadan, my theme is Quran. Everything that has to do with Quran. Recitation, tafsir, listening to Quran, memorizing Quran, reading Quran, listening to explanation, translation. My theme for this Ramadan is, plus fasting. Fasting is number one because that's the pillar. With that, it should be something else to add to. This is your goal. If you really want encouragement for this Ramadan, I could talk on this minbar for hours to prepare you for that and tell you what you need to do, which we'll do it tonight, inshallah, after Salatul Isha in the general lecture that we do and answer your questions for Ramadan. But there is one advice that I believe affects people's heart, and that advice is how to prepare for that Ramadan. You need to keep one thing in your mind. We'll talk about it, inshallah, after Jalsat al-Istiraha. أقولوا قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله وكفى وصلاة وسلاما على عباده الذين اصطفى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وبعد. What is that one thing? Adding to Quran and Siyam and Salatul Taraweeh and feeding the hungry and feeding the needy and feeding people who are fasting and supporting the fast in Ramadan, and people break their fast, so I'm gonna join in, and all this ibadat and the sadaqat, all this great ibadat, solving your disputes, holding each other's hand and say forgive me, whatever that might be. What is that one thing that could lead you to have the best Ramadan? I will tell you now. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in the salah, he used to turn around and tell the sahaba before they start salah, istawu, straighten your lines, istiqama, steadfast, wastaqimu, be on the straight path, wasallu salata muwaddi'in, and pray as if it's your last prayer. That last part is the one that I want to give you the advice for. Sum Ramadana ka'annahu akhir Ramadana laka fi hadhihi ad-dunya. Truly start off this Ramadan saying to yourself that this is my last Ramadan in this dunya. Consider it like that. It might be my last Ramadan. I'm going to leave dunya after this Ramadan, and I might not have a chance to live, which is a reality that we live in. This is not something new. كل نفس ذائقة الموت. You had family members, you had friends, you had people that they were with us last Ramadan, enjoying Ramadan, fasting Ramadan, praying Taraweeh, standing up at night and crying, witnessing Ramadan, and Allah has chosen to take their souls and they return to Allah. They did not get the opportunity that me and you, inshallah, are getting, because we don't know yet. And you remember, all of you in this masjid, what happened in September when my mother passed away. She was with us last Ramadan. Very hard to start this Ramadan without my mother. She didn't get that chance. She insisted on fasting with her sickness. And I told her, she said, well, how many Ramadan am I going to break? I have the next Ramadan and maybe the next Ramadan. And subhanAllah, she didn't have next Ramadan. She's now with her Lord. Well, wallahi, every one of us will be in that situation one day. If you think you're fighting for this dunya, you're very distracted with dunya, school is keeping you away from Allah, know that this Ramadan might be your only chance to fix your situation with Allah. And if you don't, you are the true loser that Rasulullah described. Inshallah, not you, but as the general. Rasulullah says, a person who's truly humiliated, such a person who's truly humiliated, such a person who's truly humiliated three times, and Jibreel on the minbar is making dua against such a person. Who is that? That Ramadan enters and Ramadan departs without his sins being forgiven. Don't be that person today. And wallahi, dear brothers and sisters, if any of us has the intention to fix himself and his situation with Allah and become closer to Allah this Ramadan, wallahi, even if we don't witness that Ramadan, Allah is more generous than your intention. He could give you what you intended without witnessing Ramadan. It's a sincere intention, not just a talk, not to say, Bismillah, Ramadan is coming. Most of us, wallahi, we don't seem to be ready and happy. Well, قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا. We should be happy with that. I see more Muslims being happy with the entrance of Christmas than entrance of Ramadan. This is really the situation of the ummah this day. Well, Shahru Ramadan is the month of Quran that is coming to you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the benefit of it. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to celebrate that happiness of Ramadan through our actions and implement that inshallah in our life. You know, we made the khutbah short for the brothers today. May Allah accept from them their testing. And I hope inshallah all success and in this dunya and akhirah. And remember that Ramadan is only a few days away. Start off by doing istighfar, cleaning off that heart. You know, wash your clothes before you perfume them. As Ibn Rajab said, our clothes is very dirty. So before we put perfume and make it worse, we need to clean it off first and then start off, inshallah, clean with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gain the best of the month of Ramadan. Tonight after Salatul Isha, it will be a quick review about the rules of Ramadan and question and answers, inshallah. If you are able to attend after Salatul Isha, it will be at 9:30, inshallah. Only go for about half an hour, 45 minutes, and then we could get ready for Ramadan with that preparation. Jazakumullah khairan. May Allah accept from all of you. Nas'Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yubalighna wa iyyakum Ramadan. Allahumma balighna Ramadan wa barik lana fi. Allahumma balighna Ramadan wa barik lana fi. Allahumma wahid kalimatana wajma' shamlana. Allahumma ahdi qulubana ila al-haq. اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا اللهم اجعلنا ممن يدركون رمضان ويغفر لهم يا رب العالمين والحمد لله وأقم الصلاة